Hello guys, this is Rishabh and I am legal intern in the Lexis & Company. Today's topic is on stay order. What is stay order? A stay order is nothing short of sounding a death knell to a proceeding before the trial court. Any advocate practicing in trial court would rapidly and would readily nod in affirmation to such a seemingly radical premise. The passing of such order has long badgered the progress of the trial, be it civil or criminal nature. Stay orders are passed by the higher courts with the intention of providing a temporary relief and a several instances to be provided for a much required interference and respite without which the aggrieved party would surely suffer grave injustice. However, the downside of such order is an incapable halt of the proceeding before the trial court, especially in India, where court at all level are burdened with the executing number of pending cases. The rate of disposable in a further lowered when the proceeding before the trial court are stayed. The division bench of the Supreme Court in the said appeal has identified the three major problem arising with the grant of stay order, which are: proceeding before the trial court remained pending on the account of an order of stay, proceeding are adjourned sine die on account of a grant of stay. Even in cases where the stay is vacated, intimation is not received to the trial court and proceeding are not taken up. Honorable Justice Adarsh Kumar Goyal, in the aforesaid appeal, while considering the issue at the hand, has rightly stated that the wisdom of legislature and the object of the final and the expeditious disposal of a criminal proceeding can't be ignored. As such, the Supreme Court in the said appeal on 2018 has passed the several direction applicable to the both civil and the criminal matter, which as follows: all pending cases where the stay is granted and is operating, the stay will comes to end on expiry 6 months from 2018, unless it is exceptional cases by speaking the order of stay extended. In case where a stay is granted in future, that means after 2018, the stay order will be end on the expiry of 6 months from the date of such order, unless an order extension is granted by the speaking order. The speaking order granted extension must be sure that the case was such an exceptional nature that continuing the stay was more important than having the trial finalized. The trial court may fix a date not lesser than 6 months from the date of the stay order. On expiry of the period of 6 months, the trial court to resume the proceeding without waiting for any other intimation, unless and express the order to extending the stay is produced. These directions were needed of an hour by limiting the currency of stay order to the only a 6 months, being a solely dependent of extension by the way of speaking order. The trial court can now recommend the halted proceeding without any hesitation. The onus is now cast on the party availing the order of stay to ensuring the proceeding is disposed of finally before the court stay automatically expires. The Supreme Court further qualified the nature of speaking order to show that continuing the stay order is more important than having the trial continuing or finalized. Okay, these direction will be surely ensure the speedy disposal of cases and delivery of prompt justice to parties. Thank you very much guys. This is my video assignment on the topic of stay order. Like and comment for your feedback. Your feedback is most important for us. Thank you very much.